Okay, thank you. So yeah, I'll be talking about implementing Signal. This is a joint work with Yi Tang, who is a master student at NYU. So this is my, I don't know how to put the pointer, this is my favorite Signal implementation, maybe this one, but I was told it's not good for a master project, so instead we did this. So what we decided to kind of implement Signal protocol for the reason I'm going to talk next. So the details, in fact, you can probably hardly see, but this is a yeah, web page for the program. You can like download the code. This is a website, so you can also there is a link on my web page. So what is this project about? So briefly, I will tell you, you know, why we did the specification, implementation, and even the benchmarking. So you probably know that Signal is a very popular platform for end-to-end messaging. It's pretty much used by everybody now, most notably WhatsApp. So it has more than 1 billion users, won the real-world cryptography election prize. So very, very important protocol. It has many implementations. Some of them are even open source. But for those of you who know, it's a very complex thing. It's hard to teach in class. It's kind of very confusing. Also, various models are really interleaved. It's heavily based on Diffie-Hellman. So somehow, it's a beautiful protocol, but until recently, maybe it wasn't completely clear why it works, what is really going on. So what we did in this Eurocrypt jointly with Joel Alvin and Sandra Coretti, who is here, we tried to write a paper which modularized Signal and explain what Signal is and also give simple generalization and really proves it secure and so on. This is what we did. We customized Signals by using different modules, and Signal was a special case of this implementation. But now with this thing, you can just literally like jigsaw puzzle, plug in different things. For example, you can get post-quantum Signal. So this is, again, I don't expect you to read it. This is really our generalized Signal. It looks kind of long, but it's really not you know, that hard. It's intuitive. You can teach it in class. For those of you who know the original Signal, arguably it's like much, much simpler. It has various modules. Yeah, there is like encryption, decryption, and so on. So there are various modules which are natural and simple, something called continuous key agreement, pseudorandom function generator, which is like a fancy way for a hash function, standard pseudorandom generator or stream cipher, any authenticated encryption, and from these things in a pretty clean way, using the previous picture, you get generalized Signal, which existing Signal is a special case. We also did, I mean, as I said, details not matter, but we showed like extensive constructions of various blocks from simpler blocks. So really following down the tree, you literally has like dozens of various possibilities for Signal, depending on what hash function you like, what stream cipher you like, what public encryption you like, and so on. And indeed, this is kind of apparent from the code. So what we did, we had this bottom-up kind of way to implement this library. You can like plug in all kinds of components instead of continuous key agreements, the hash functions, PRG, and so on. And you know, have implementation seen. But of course, this is my first programming supervision project, so I'm sure we did something suboptimally, so please improve it. It's all open source and so on. So just kind of to give you an example, the original Signal is like a special case where CKA comes from something called, you know, the compressed Diffie-Hellman kind of key agreement. You know, the hash function is HKDF based, PRG is based on like SHA-256, and use AES 128 SAV. But then just kind of to play with it, we wanted to say, okay, let's do post-quantum implementation of Signal, just go to a master project. So we chose the simplest one. It's highly kind of maybe non-optimized, but we chose like Frodo, which is based on LW. It's like super simple, clean, but you know, the ciphertext and public keys are long. So probably not the best choice for a practical thing, but still just kind of as a concept implementation. This is like the choices that get us one thing. Then we did something to optimize it. We did compress Frodo, which saved like a factor of 2 in communications and all the parameters, which was kind of nice. And so this slide shows what the world has come to. Maybe it has will come to an end. It's like the first time I have a plot on stage in a talk. So this is a historic moment. You know, I will have 2 of them even. So thank you. I mean, it's all due to E. I mean, I don't know how to do plots, so he did it. But yeah, just even with the basic, this fraud implementation, we just like, this is a standard Signal, this is the efficiency, this is optimized fraud, this is fraud. So in terms of efficiency, it's actually pretty much, you know, factor of 2-3, which is significant, but not outrageous. But yeah, if you care about cost quantum, it's kind of really simple. this is like the first implementation. There is a slide missing, I think, but all right. So there was even the important thing, which maybe the slide missing. I saw they updated it, but anyways, that even of course the big things is the packet cost. So the packet cost, of course, the public keys in Froda are much longer than in Diffie-Hellman. But you know, for long enough messages, it's again tolerable. And if you use like New Hope or something like that, hopefully you will get something reasonable. So I would love to see post-quantum signal maybe as an option in WhatsApp or something like that. So if some of you are interested, you know, please talk to me or just do it. I mean, you have all the code, all the modules you can just easily kind of implement it. So these are some of the references to the papers. And for the first time, I even have a few seconds. I'm finishing a few seconds early.